said, Father, what I'm about to do, don't do it for me. Keep on waiting. But in your waiting, know that he can show up and show out quickly. God will answer prayer. He may not come when you want him to, but he's always on time.
Welcome to you.
come on, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. I am so thankful and so grateful that you have decided to join us right here, Union Baptist Church, Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Thank you for joining us. Please share this message and let someone know that we're here to bring inspiration to you. I want you to turn your Bibles with me to Ezekiel, the 37th chapter. Right there, the 13th verse, Ezekiel 37, verse 13, verse 15, and it says, the word of the Lord came again unto me, saying, moreover, thou son of man, take thee one stick and write upon it for Judah and for the children of Israel, his companions. Then take another stick and write upon it for Joseph, the stick of Ephraim, and for all of the house of Israel, his companions. Join them one to another, one stick, and they shall become one in thine hand. And when the children of thy people shall speak unto thee, saying, wilt thou show us, and what does this mean? Say unto them, said the Lord, behold, I will take the stick of Joseph, which is the hand of Ephraim, and the tribes of Israel, his fellows, and will put with them the stick of Judah, and make them one stick. And they shall be one in mine hand. I want to talk this message through, and I want to talk from this subject. Things are coming together. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand praise, and you ought to celebrate the fact that things are coming together. I have discovered that whenever the enemy wants to disturb you, discourage you, and distract you, he will get in your mind and make you think that your prayers, your dreams, your visions, and desires will never come together. But before you count God out and throw in the towel, know that God's ways are not your ways. God's thoughts are not your thoughts. And even when it looks like things are not necessarily working out and things are not coming together, rest assured that things are coming together. For the word declares in Romans that the sufferings of this present time cannot compare to the glory that shall be revealed. Romans 8 and 28 says that, and we know that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. What I'm trying to tell you is that it may not look like it, but I have come right now to tell you that certainly things are coming together. If you take two magnets, they will have two opposite poles. One is called the North Pole and one is called a South Pole. And if you would take those magnets and put them together the right way, they will attract one another. But if you take those magnets and hold them the wrong way, the forces between them won't allow them to come together. And beloved, I want you to know that there are forces at work in your life that are trying to hinder some things from coming together for you. But I come to tell you that God says that in this season, he's about to defeat every foe, every enemy, every work of witchcraft that is seeking to work against the plans that God has established for your life. God is about to come, and God is working on your behalf to make certain that those forces do not keep things from coming together. That was the message that God gave Ezekiel to tell Israel when he sent him last week, I just showed you, to a graveyard full of dry bones. I tried to show you last week that Ezekiel had one sermon to preach, And that sermon was indeed that these bones can live. Help me, Holy Ghost. And let me say this, that it doesn't matter what kind of dry, decaying, and mortalizing season you have been in, the word declares that you can live. I wish you would just put in the chat box and tell somebody that you can live. You can live. You can live. I don't care what the prognosis is. You shall live. It doesn't matter if you're hooked up to a CPAP, a BiPAP, or if you're on a ventilator. If God says that you can live, you can live. I wish you would just let somebody know that I'm glad to be alive. It was after Ezekiel prophesied these words that the bones started making a noise and they came together. Help me, Holy Ghost. I want y'all to know that when God begins to pull things together, it starts with how you think and how you process and how you understand God to move in your life. So don't you know that the functionality of things coming together in your life often starts with how you think. The biggest wall you have to climb is the one that you build in your mind. Thinking is more about courage than intelligence. It takes courage to think about you being more than you are. You going somewhere that you have never been. It takes courage to do something that you have never done. Thinking is about courage more than it is intelligence. I like what Gandhi said. Gandhi said a long time ago, I'm not going to let anybody walk through my mind that has dirty feet. Help me, Holy Ghost. If people bring you stinking thinking, then you have the potential of becoming stinking thinking. I don't have time for stinking thinking in my life. That thinking that does not do anything for my esteem, my character, didn't do anything for who I am in the image that God created me to be. As a man or woman thinketh, so is he or she. But I want you to know that these bones came together. Now, God is sending now that same message again through Ezekiel. But this time, he's not using bones, but this time he's using sticks. This time he tells Ezekiel to gather two sticks. I want you to take two sticks and I want you to put one in each hand. One stick representing Judah and the other stick representing Joseph. He says by now Israel has become a divided kingdom. The kingdom had been divided and they had placed division over the divinity of God. They had become a divided kingdom and they had placed division over God's divinity. I want you to know that they were a divided nation. They tried to remain divided. They were divided over small stuff. They let small stuff come between them. Who was the greatest and who had the most stuff? And they let the little things come between them. Who looked the best and who had more favor than the other? Don't that sound a little bit like us? We let little small things come between us. Yes, we hang out together. We may fellowship together. We spend all this kind of time together. We may sing in the choir together, usher together, praise, dance together, worship together, and then we let the enemy come between us with little silly small stuff. They let small stuff come between them. They once were together, but now they were separated. And don't you know that God was sick and tired of their pettiness, of letting things separate them? And so now God says, says, I'm tired of it, and I'm now about to bring them together. God says, take one stick in one hand. That represents Judah and all the tribes with him. And then take another stick in another hand. That represents Joseph and all the tribes with him. Right now they are separate, but then what I want you to do, Ezekiel, I want you to put the two sticks together. Help me, Holy Ghost, to let the tribes know that that which was dividing them is now coming together, and what was separated is now becoming one. God says that no longer will the enemy come between you, but things are now coming together. Can we have a conversation for just a few moments? Because it seems that for the past few years, the enemy has been trying to wreak havoc in the lives of some of you who are listening to me right now. What I'm trying to tell you, that it looks like things are working against us, but don't you know that God shall never be defeated? I want you to know that this is a picture of the Antichrist. What's going on in our nation today, when we have elected officials that are backing an agenda called the big lie? I want you to know that if you have any God on the inside of you, you cannot stand behind any agenda called a lie. I wish I had some help in here. As a matter of fact, the devil is a lie. I shall not stand behind any poster called the big lie, any politician that bears the banner of a big lie, because Jesus says that I am the way, the truth, and the light. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. I want y'all to know that we are about truth and not a lie. And I want you to put in the chat box and tell somebody, we got to stand for the truth and not a lie. Can we have more of a conversation? It looks like things are being torn apart, but underneath the surface, God is always bringing things together. Don't you know, church, it looks like the enemy is winning, but don't you give the devil too much credit. God is still in control. Can you tap somebody and tell them God is still in control? Don't you know that the one who is trying to build up obstacles, God still is in control. He has the enemy right there in his view. Don't you ever think God is not in control of the enemy as well? Don't you know that when they came upon me to eat of my flesh, they stumbled and they failed? I had a little member in my church some years ago. I was teaching that passage in Bible study. And one of my little elderly members said, Pastor, can I say something? I said, go ahead, baby. She said, I don't believe that the enemy just stumbled and fell. She said, I believe that God tripped them while they were on their way. Can I tell you that God has a way of tripping your enemy, that when they think that they're undoing, and when they think that they're sowing seed of discourse, when they think that they're tearing something up, God is still bringing it together. I want you to know that we serve a God who is bringing things together. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but to the one who's starting a business, I know it looks like you will never get it off the ground. You got to do a business plan. They're making you work on a marketing plan, and you don't know what you're going to do about packaging. You got to find a bank to finance you. You don't have enough money. You don't know where you're going to get the van from. You don't know where you're going to get the logo from. I know you're getting tired of people saying you got to go on and do it, but you don't have all of the resources. But I want to tell you, don't give up and don't turn around. Don't you give in. Don't throw in the towel, but just hang on in there and keep on pressing, because things are coming together. I remember when I was at school at Duke University, Don't you know, I called home my first semester and I called my mother and I said, Mama, I said, I'm on my way home. I said, Duke is everything they said it is. I said, I cannot make it. It's too hard down here. It's too much reading and too much writing, and the professors just don't understand that there's more to life than just reading and writing. I said, it's too hard. I'm about to pack up my room and I'm coming home. And don't you know, my mother said on the other end of the phone, she listened patiently and she said, are you finished? And I said, yes, ma'am. She said, well, let me tell you something. She said, you're not packing up and you're not coming home. She said, don't you let words on a piece of paper master the brain that God put in your head. She said, now you need to go settle down because you ain't leaving nowhere. You're going back and you're going to stay there until you finish. She said, and after a while, you'll see things come together. I want you to know that I'm so glad that she spoke into my life, because after a while, I saw things come together. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but there's somebody whose home is in disarray, because the family dynamics are changing. The finances have changed. The children ain't children no more. The relationship has been through so many ups and downs, and now you're calling the ups downs and the downs ups. You just glad for the second of peace between the two of you. But the word for you today is that don't confuse a bad day with the end. Help me, Holy Ghost. Just because it's a bad day don't mean it's the end. But would you please put in the chat box and tell somebody to hang on in there. Things are coming together. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but God is about to bring some things together. He's about to change somebody's address. Would you please put in the chat box and tell somebody that the preacher is talking to me, because God is about to change my atmosphere. He's about to move you from one job to another job, from one book to another book. What I'm trying to tell you is that things are coming together, and he's about to change your atmosphere. Do I have a witness in here? Then God says that I'm about to gather my people from the north, from the south, from the east, and from the west, and I'm going to expand the family circle. In other words, God says that when they come together, I'm about to introduce them to some new cousins, some new family that they ain't never seen before. Good God Almighty, I'm so glad that we got a God on our side, that when one person in your life starts acting funny, God will send somebody else that knows how to show up to carry the load that's on your back. Do I have a witness in here? If it takes one person out, he'll send seven others. Do I have a witness in here? If three start acting funny, he'll send 30 to stand by your way. If you lose one prayer partner, he got 300 others that'll stand with you, that'll hold up your arms. God says, I'm sending you friends. I'm sending you family from the north, from the south, from the east, and from the west. Say yes, say yes, say yes. And then don't you know, God says, Ezekiel, I want you to go and tell Judah and tell Joseph that when they come together, that I will save them, and I will cleanse them. And I'm so glad that I got a God that's on my side. He walks with me, he talks with me. I'm so glad that he saved me. I don't know who I'm talking to, but you ought to be glad that if the Lord doesn't never do anything else, he's already done enough. He's done enough when he saved me, when he cleansed me. Now somebody said, when did he save me? Well, he saved me when they marched him up the Via Della Rosa, when they put a cross on his back, and they hung him high, and they stretched him wide, and they put nails, thank you, man, they put nails in his hands, and they put nails, oh, shucks, in his feet, good God Almighty. And don't you know, while hanging there on the cross, he was saving me. I was worth him dying for. I was too mean to live, and I wasn't fit to die, but he saved me. He cleansed me. He washed me. Yeah, he saved me. And somebody looked down through the dim mysteries of time and said, must Jesus bear the cross alone and all the world go free? There is a cross for everyone, and yes, there's a cross for me. I'm so glad that he saved me. He spilled his blood when they put crowns on his head. He bled when they nailed him in his hands. He bled when they pierced him in his side. He bled, yeah, but I was worth it. He kept on dying. He didn't stop dying. He kept.
We invite you to make a contribution to the ministry. Through your giving, we reach our community and expand his kingdom. And we recognize the one who gave us everything. To give, you can use technology. Use the Push app or go to giving page on the Union Baptist website. Use the Cash app.
$UBC1200
Use the Givelify app. Union Baptist Church, Winston-Salem. Let us show love through giving.